Hey everyone! In this video, I'm going to be teaching you how to get Snapchat filters onto your PC so you can include them in your streams, your YouTube videos, and whatever else you want. Things like video chats and stuff like that. Anything on your computer that includes your face, you can have these filters. So I will be teaching you using this program called Snap Camera. It's a super easy software to download and use. So if you want to know how to use it, stick around and I'm going to teach you how. All right, so all you're really going to have to do to get this program is go to snapcamera.snapchat.com. And once you go there, you should be on this page. And then, of course, we really just want to hit the download button. Agree to the stuffs. Put your email in. Oops. Tell them you're not a robot. And then choose either for Mac or for PC. We're going to go ahead and double click the setup. It'll ask you for permission. Just go ahead and hit OK. And this is what the screen looks like. We've all kind of downloaded something before and installed it. So just hit next. You can create a desktop shortcut if you'd like, and hit next again. And then you'll go ahead and hit install. And after that, we'll just be opening up the program and I'll show you what that looks like. Once you open up the program after it's installed, this is kind of going to be what it looks like for you. We'll have all the different filters under here, and we can hit the little star in the left-hand corner to favorite anyone we want, or copy a link, download the code, all that good stuff. Over on the right here, you'll see your settings. This is what that looks like. And then if we go back and come over to the top left-hand side and go to our favorites, we'll see all of our favorite filters over here. And then of course, lastly, we have our lens hotkeys. This is gonna be a great area for you to learn how to get to because this is gonna be your hotkeys on how to activate and deactivate your filters with the touch of a couple buttons. So yeah, that's gonna be super important for you. So now I'm just gonna go ahead and show you a couple of examples on what the filters look like, both just in the program itself, as well as what it'll look like in your OBS or streaming software. Okay, so now that we've seen all of the cool filters in here and, you know, all of our favorites, all that kind of thing, I do want to show you kind of what other capabilities this program does have that's really cool that you can use in your stream or whatever else. So obviously this is our settings here, and we can choose our microphone, our camera, the resolution, choose if we want it to start up on, you know, when you boot your computer up. You can flip the video preview, and then you can also come down here and edit some hotkeys for like video recording, taking pictures, and doing like the lens effects. One thing I did want to show you how to do as well is if you come up here to your favorites tab and go right here to where it says lens hotkeys, this is what's going to really be useful for you. So after you have set your favorite filters, you can come in here and add a hotkey for it. This will give you like a huge amount of access to all your filters and to turn them on and off quickly. So say we set this one to control number 7, and then we save that. Head back out and do control 7. We're the Among Us guy now. And then if you do it again, it comes off. Really, really super cool. My chat really loves it. I even have a channel point for activating some of the filters for a set amount of time, and it's just really a good time, and I think it's a great addition to your stream or whatever content you might be making. So this is what my OBS studio looks like. Now if yours doesn't look exactly like mine, that is totally okay. Just make sure that you do have the most recent version, and you shouldn't have any problems at all. All this stuff here on the sides and all that is just my little customization, so you don't have to worry about that if yours doesn't look like that. All you're gonna do is go to the scene you'd like, and come to the sources right here. Then you'll come down to the plus sign and hit video capture device. A lot of you will be familiar on how to add this, but I do just wanna add a little snippet in here just in case you need any help at all. Once you go there, then you will hit the drop down next to device and you'll find snap camera. This, as you can see, is capturing just the picture slash video portion of the snap camera software. So if you want to mess with any of these settings, you can. It's not needed for me, so just click OK, and that's literally it. I'll give you a little preview here. This is really all it is. This is exactly what it looks like. It is so easy, especially how you can just add it in literally just as a video capture device, just as you would any other webcam. That's it. Really highly recommend it. Of course, if you guys have any questions, please let me know in the comments. You can also come to my stream and ask me any questions, or we do also have a Discord and a bunch of socials, so if you have a question, please do come find me. I will be more than happy to help you out with whatever you need. And until next time, guys, drink lots of water, eat some food, take care of yourselves, and give yourself a break every once in a while. Bye-bye.